Hello everyone, today we are going to study chapter number 3, polynomial, practice set number 3.6. We are going to complete in today's video. So let's start with the first question. Now, simple factorization method that we have learned since 8th standard, the same thing we have to do it in this video as well. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to multiply the first and the last term. Okay, that means this is the first term and this is the last term. You all have to multiply. So 2 into 1 is supposed to be how much? 2. Okay, and by addition and subtraction, you all should be able to get plus 1. 1 because over here it is plus 1. Okay, if in case you all are not able to understand, you all can watch my day before yesterday's video. Factorization for the 8th standard has been completed. That video, you all can watch it. It's a basic, but I think it is more than sufficient for you all to understand. Okay, so when we have to find the middle term, okay, splitting the middle term, you all have to multiply the first and the last term. That is 2 ones are 2. And by addition and subtraction, you all should be able to get the middle term. That is 1. So plus 1. So how are you going to get? Obviously, 2 ones are 2 plus and minus minus. And the sign of the bigger number, 2 minus 1 is going to be 1. It's that simple. We have done this. It's basic. So 2x square plus 2x minus x. You all don't have to take 1 over here. Okay. Even if you all take, it's not going to make any difference. Okay. So, now split the terms in such a way that you will be able to get the common terms in the bracket. Okay. So, using these, what we have done, 2x I have taken common from this section. Okay. So, 2x into x will be 2x square. Okay. 2x into 1 will be 2x. Same as for here, we have taken 1 common over here. X plus 1 is going to be 1 into 1 is going to be 1. And 1 into x is going to be x. So, you all have got one common bracket, that is x plus 1. And 1 this bracket, that is 2x minus 1. Now, the second sum is 2m square plus 5m minus 3. Okay, now over here again what we have to do, we have to multiply the first and the last term, that is 2 threes are 6. Okay, so 6 we have to get and we have to split the middle term in such a way that you will get plus 5. Okay, so what is going to be the factors? 6 into 1. So 6 ones are 6 plus and minus minus 6 minus 1 is going to be 5. Okay, so you all have to use instead of plus 5m, these terms you all, it is these factors you all have to use, or these terms you all have to use. That is 2m square plus 6m minus m minus 3. Now from this you all have to take the common terms. Now 2 you all have to take common, then m you all can take common. Over here we will only take m, so that 2m into m will be 2m square plus 2 threes are 6 and m is going to be as it is. Minus 1 common from here and m plus 3. So you all have got 2 same bracket and the other one is 2m minus 1. Now let's do the third one. That is 12x square plus 61x plus 77. Okay, now what you all have to do now, 12 into 77, if you are going to multiply these two terms as we have done multiplication over here, 2 threes are 6. 12 into 77 will be a 4-digit number, which will be very difficult for us to find the factors, isn't it? So what we can do is 12 into 77. Okay, 12 into 77. So the factors for 12 is 4 threes are 12 and for 77 is 11 into 7. Got it? So what we are doing, we are splitting it in such a way that we will get the common numbers. Okay. Now what you all have to do, 4 sevens are 28 and 3 elevens are 33. Okay. Now 28 plus 33 is going to be 61, which is supposed to be a middle term. That means which terms you all have to take, children? 28 and 33. When you multiply it, you all are going to get the answer that is going to be for 12 into 77. Okay. And after addition, you are going to get the middle term, that is 61. Isn't this step simple? It's very simple. You all have to just understand it. Okay. It's very simple. Now, what you all have to place 28 and 33 instead of 61. So, it is going to be 2m square. 12x square, not 2m square, 12x square plus 28x plus 33x plus 77. Okay, now place your brackets. 4 we can take common, 4x we will take. Okay, so 4 3s are 12 and one more x we will take. So x into x is going to be x square plus 4 7s are 28. X is already here, so no need to take x over here. Now for this we will take 11 common. Okay, so 11 we have taken common. So 11 3s are 33. X is not here, so you all have to take x over here. And 11 7s are 77. So you all have got one common bracket. So write the common bracket, that is 3x plus 7 and 4x plus 11. Got it? So don't get mixed up with this. If you all are not able to understand this step, please let me know in the comment section, children. Now, the fourth one is 3y square minus 2y minus 1. Okay, now again 3 into 1 you all have to multiply, that is going to be 3. Split it in such a way that you will be able to get minus 2. Okay, so obviously 3 ones are 3 minus and plus over here. Okay, multiply 3 you will get, subtracted you are going to get 2, minus 2 you all are going to get. So 3y square minus 3y plus y minus 1. So 3y, y minus 1 plus 1, y minus 1. So common bracket you all have got. Okay, why I am underlining this, children, it's for your understanding. You all don't need to underline it. Okay, it's for your explanation. 3y plus 1 is going to be in the second bracket. Now let's do the fifth one. Now fifth one is also a little different. Root 3x square plus 4x plus root 3. Okay, now see, root 3 into root 3, what we are going to get? Root 3 into root 3 is supposed to be 3, isn't it? This is the logic. So 3 into 1 is going to be 3 and 3 plus 1 is going to be 4. Got it? So we need 4. We have got it. 3 into 3, 3 into 1 is going to be 3. That is what we need. So root 3x square plus 3x plus x plus root 3. Okay, so middle term only you all have to split. X plus root 3 plus 1, x plus root 3. Okay, common you all have got. X plus root 3 and root 3x plus 1. So this is under 1 root. Okay, so here your answer is complete for the fifth one. Now let's move on to the sixth sum. It is half. Now this is in the form of a fraction, so don't get afraid. It's even more easy. Okay, now what you all have to do, 1 into 4 we are not going to get anything, so we all have to multiply 2 into 4. Okay, why we are multiplying it? So that we will get 8. 8 we all have got. Find the factor such that you will get minus 3. Okay, or we can do one step. We will not take 8, we will take directly 4. Okay, because see, 1 into 4 is going to be 4. So let's take 4 over here in such a way that after multiplication and division you all should be able to get minus 3. So let's not take a multiplication also. If you all are going to reduce it, see, it is going to be 2 ones are and 2 twos are. Okay, see, over here I will do it so it will be more clear. 2 ones are and 2 twos are. So what is left over here? 2 is left over here. Okay, and after addition and subtraction, you all should be able to get minus 3. So what are the factors? The factors are going to be minus 2, minus 1. Okay, minus and minus is going to be plus. 2 plus 1 is going to be 3. Sign of the bigger number, 2 into minus 1 is going to be, so 2 into 1 is going to be 2. Got it? And from where did we get 2, children? We get 2 from the reduction of this fraction. Okay, so let's not move into that 8 wala thing. It is a bit difficult. Let's do it as we have done the other sums. So this is the easiest way. We have done almost all the sums from this method. So let's use this method only for this sum also. Okay, so I think it is clear. And from where did we get this 2 at instead of 4? By reducing the fraction. Okay, so simple. 1 upon 2 x square. This is for your understanding. Okay. Actually, y'all should not cut it. It is that we have to keep carry on these first and the last terms, isn't it? It is for your understanding that why we have taken 2. Okay, so in the rough column, y'all have to do it. Not add it 2 over here instead of 4. So the term is going to be minus 2x minus x plus 4. I hope this step is clear to everyone. Now from here this is going to be common. So half you all have to take x, x in bracket minus 4 minus 1 x minus 4. Okay, so the common bracket is x minus 4 and the uncommon is 1 upon 2 x minus 1. So how did we get 4 over here, children? You all might be wondering. So 2 into 2 is going to be 4. See, when you multiply 1 upon 2 in x into x, you are going to get this term. 1 upon 2 minus 4, you all are going to get. See, when you did again, the same step over here is going to be carried out. Okay. So 2 ones are 2 twos are. So the answer is going to be minus 2x. So because of the fraction, don't get confused. This you all can write it and keep it so that the teacher will understand it. And you all have to place minus 4 instead of minus 2. And why we are doing it? Because we have to get minus 2. Isn't it? After reduction, you are going to get minus 2 only. So you all have to take minus 4 over here. Now the question number 2 is factorize the following polynomials. Okay, now this is the second question. You all can follow the textbook. From this exercise, we will be doing 2 questions in this video and the other question I will be doing in the next video. Okay, which will be part 2 of this exercise. Okay, now what we have to do, you will see that this bracket is same, isn't it? So what we have to do, substituting m. Instead of writing this complete bracket, you all have to substitute it m for x square minus x. So instead of this, you all have to write m. So the equation is going to change. This is going to be m square. Instead of this, we are writing m minus 8m plus 12. Now it has become easy. Now from here onwards, you all have to follow the same step as we did for the factorization. Got it? So this is going to change to m square minus 2m minus 6m plus 12. Okay, what we have done over here, again the same thing, 1 into 12. Okay, and the factors are going to be minus 2 minus 6 in order to get minus 8, that is the middle term. From here, the same step as we did for question number 1 is going to be followed. Only the separate step that we have taken is only the substituting one. Okay, rest everything is same. Now we have got the pairs. So it is going to be m common from here. M minus 2 minus 6. M minus 2. Okay. So 6 into m is going to be 6m. 6 minus 2 is going to be 12. M into m, m square. M into 2 is going to be 2m. So m minus 2 and m minus 6. Now till here only we have learned, isn't it? Now from here also there is going to be a step. Now what is m? M, what is there? We have taken m as x square minus x. So you all have to place the value x square minus x minus 2. So this is going to be the next step after completing the squares. Now x is x square minus x minus 6. Got it? So this is the only difference over here. Now what you all have to do, x square minus 2x, okay, multiply these two terms, plus x minus 2. Over here also, x square minus 3x plus 2x minus 6. So what we have done over here, children, separately we have found the factors. Okay, so for minus 2, the factors are going to be minus 2 into plus 1. Okay, for this, see, 1 into 2 is going to be minus 2. For minus 1, you'll have to multiply 2 into 1 to get minus 2. And minus 2 plus 1 is going to be minus 1. Okay, so these factors you all have found from this one. Okay, over here 1 was there. So 1 into 6 is going to be minus 6. Okay, so what factors we have taken? Minus 3 plus 2. Minus 3 plus 2 to get minus 1 again. So 3 2s are 6 plus and minus minus. So 3 minus 2 is going to be 1. So again, you all have got the common terms in order to find the common brackets. Got it? So in this way, you all have to find, after substituting फाइंड द फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड फॉर द मेन पार्ट. आफ्टर दैट यू आर गोइंग टू गेट टू ब्रैकेट. फॉर द टू सेपरेट ब्रैकेट यू ऑल हैव टू रीसब्स्टिट्यूटेड द वैल्यू ऑफ द ब्रैकेट दैट वी हैव टेकन. After that, again factorization you all have to do. Okay, so this step is known as refactorization. Okay, again you all have to refactorize it because we have already done it. Now after substituting, you are going to get the real answer. So for this, it is going to be x minus 2 for this. Okay, x into x is going to be x square. X into minus 2 is going to be 2 minus 2x plus 1. We will take common. X, so 1 into x is going to be x, 1 into minus 2 is going to be 2. Okay, so this is your first bracket. Now the second one is x square. So x into x is going to be x square minus 3. X into 3 is going to be 3x plus, from here we will take 2 common, x minus 3 again, because 2 into x is going to be 2x, 2 into minus 3 is going to be minus 6. So this is your second expansion. Okay, now what we have to do, take the common bracket from this one, that is x minus 2, and uncommon one is x plus 1. So four factors you all are going to get. X minus 3 is 1 and x plus 2 is going to be the other one. You all can watch this video again, and I'm sure with the practice you are going to get this sum very easily. Now let's do the second sum. And after this, the other sums will be solved in the next video, children. So do follow me if you all are not able to understand it, because a new method, or we can change the method if you all are not able to understand. Now what we have to do, we will make one common bracket. Okay, kaise? From here we can take 5 common, x and 5 minus 24. Okay, so what we have to do, square is there, so don't worry about that, but the bracket is same. So substituting, what you all can take, m for x minus 5, x minus 5 ke liye m lena hai. So this equation is changed to m square minus 5m minus 24. So m square minus 8m plus 3m minus 24. Okay, so I will explain it over here. 24, so 8 threes are 24, minus and plus minus, minus 5 you are going to get. Got it? So this is going to change to m minus 8 plus 3 m minus 8. So it is going to be m minus 8 in one bracket and m plus 3 in the other bracket. Resubstitute the value. M के जगह पे क्या लेना था, x माइनस 5. सो x माइनस 5 माइनस 8 इन वन ब्रैकेट एंड x माइनस 5 प्लस 3 इन अदर ब्रैकेट. ओके, रीसब्स्टिट्यूटिंग द वैल्यूज. नाउ ओवर हियर वी कैन डायरेक्टली सॉल्व इट. ओके, हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व इट, सी प्लस एंड माइनस इज गोइंग टू बी प्लस. सो प्लस 13. ओके, सो अगेन ओवर हियर माइनस एंड प्लस इज गोइंग टू बी माइनस. सो 5 माइनस 3 इज गोइंग टू बी माइनस 2. So this was easy, isn't it? So in this way, we have to solve the factorization of the polynomial. See you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye.